Hi, gang. I'm glad you're all here. I really appreciate you joining me. I hope everyone is enjoying their Tuesday. Today is February 1st, 2022. There was another earthquake there in Southern California. Yeah, Southern California gets a lot of them. But this one was strong enough where 1,008 people reported to USGS that they felt the earthquake. This was along the Compton Thrust Fault, and it was a thrust earthquake. And I wonder if it had anything to do with yesterday's earthquake of the magnitude 4.1 that was down south along the Eleanor's Fault Zone. Both of these earthquakes were thrust earthquakes. 5,757 people said they felt that earthquake. Here's the moment tensor ball for today's earthquake. Here's an example of a thrust earthquake where one fault line rises up, slides up over the other fault line, which would be A. So this looks like to be a normal thrust earthquake, not a reverse thrust earthquake. The 4.1 that occurred earlier yesterday in Southern California, that was a reverse thrust earthquake. Both thrust and reverse thrust earthquakes are very dangerous. If out in the ocean, they can create tsunamis. So this is the 4.1, which was a reverse thrust earthquake, and the 3.3, which was a regular thrust earthquake. Here I have a link for you. It'll be down below in the description box. The main difference between reverse thrust fault, now that's what occurred yesterday, and thrust faults is that a reverse fault, one side of the land moves up while the other side remains still, whereas thrust fault is a break in the earth's crust across which older rocks are pushed above younger ones. It's also got to do with how much of a dip, how much the angle of the fault that moved. The reverse thrust fault was a deep, steep slope where just a regular thrust earthquake is a gentle slope. It's not as steep. And then a normal one. These are all slip dip faults. So again, going to today's earthquake, you can see it's just kind of a gentle little slope here that it moved. And then, how the one from yesterday, that was a steep angular dip. Both these earthquakes rose, one side of the fault rose up over the other. But today's earthquake, the angle was more gentle, not as dramatic as yesterday's. Going to the USGS map, here we can get a better idea of location. We got Santa Monica, we got Long Beach, etc. So did you feel this earthquake? Some of the felt reports on EMSC said, I felt it. I thought it was a big truck dumping something. They felt this one in their chest like a boom. Felt two quick jolts, shook the house a little. They live in Bell, California. Another one said they had a quick jolt. Very small shake in Bell. Lasted no more than 2 seconds. They were doing yoga on the floor and then they felt the jolt. Big bump and a quick shake. Thought it was a truck ramming into our loading dock at first. A few reports from Paramount felt the slight movement at first and then a quick, like a knock. Paramount, California. Quick shake, little shake and a rattle, a jolt. Heard it coming, then felt a jolt. We felt a hard jolt and shaking for a brief second. That quick jolt was when the fault line suddenly jumped up. Bam, right? Everyone is reporting that it was a quick shake. Yeah, it just went bam, pow. Yeah, the fault broke. It is a densely populated area where this earthquake occurred. How did your pet react prior to and after the earthquake? Did you have any damage? More likely not with a 3.3. Was there any difference? Some people say they have earthquake weather prior to an earthquake that they can feel. Some people feel nauseated. Some people feel dizzy. Did any of that happen to you before this earthquake? Please put that information down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.